some crackers, some chips, some salami, cheese, whatever you like. Get your parents ready, because it's going to be a great show. Get them all sitting around. It's going to be a good time. It's going to be show 14. Cut away.
Welcome to another edition of Cutaway. I'm Brett Dixon.
And I'm Mike Williams, and we're at the San Leandro Marina. It's a pleasant day out here, Brett, don't you agree?
Yeah, it's a little windy, though.
Yeah, a little windy, I have to say. But later on in the day, this place is going to be covered with windsurfers, so I'm looking forward to that. Mm-hmm. So, Brett, can you tell us, like, what's going to be on the show today?
I've got a story about some fat fishermen.
Cindy from Alameda High tells us about windsurfing on the bay.
Christy DeZotti, our new contributor here on Cutaway, will take us behind the scenes of the making of Ruthless People.
Emmett has a story from the Wilbur Street Art Gallery.
Jose has a review of Blue Velvet.
Simon has a review of the TV show Alf.
A frisbee-catching dog named Ashley Whippet.
And I have a skate video from Alameda High School.
So both Mike and I hope you stay with us for the next 30 minutes here on Cutaway.
You look really nice, Brett, the bow tie and everything.
Yep.
I like it. Well, here's Ben's story to tell you more about Cutaway.
Cutaway is a video magazine produced especially for you local cable viewers and this cable station. It's a compilation of video clips, features, some seen for the first time, and our regular Cutaway contributors. So stay tuned for another 30 minutes of Cutaway, and now for our first story, let's go back to Brett Dixon.
We're here in San Francisco, well, the wharf, and these are some of the best fed, fattest seals here in San Francisco. So let's check them out. Actually, these fishermen don't have to work too hard. The fish come to them.
Come on, baby. Come on. Good boy.
The sea lions come into the wharf every year to feed off the scraps they get from the restaurants and tourists. And this year, they decided to stay because the fresh salmon and halibut just kept coming. Every morning, Jessie Williams blows her whistle, and the meal starts.
Come here, Sammy. Baby, come here. Sammy is the one with the white cap and white whiskers. His name was given by one of the fishermen around here. And the rest, as you get to know their face, you give them names. Yeah. Sammy!
Officials who work at the wharf say it is unusual for the sea lions to stay.
Normally each year they'd follow in the herring boats at the end of herring season and stay for a week or two and then go back out to sea.
If you gave me salmon every day, I'd stick around too.
So now the famous food at the wharf is now becoming a habit for the undersea world as well. You're watching Cutaway, and Simon Tinkstrom is next, and
he's 12 years old and goes to Winton Junior High.
Simon is going to be showing us some clips from the new TV series Alf.
So let's check it out.
Hi, I'm Simon Tinkstrom for Cutaway. And there's a new show that's on this season called ALF, which stands for Alien Life Form. The show is about an alien who crash lands into a suburban house after his planet is destroyed.
We have a visitor.
The household is made up of a father and mother and two children, a teenage girl and a young boy. The family has to devote full time to keeping Alf out of trouble, hiding him from the neighbors, and keeping him from eating their cat.
Willie, will you come down to Earth for a minute? An alien being has come to live with us and eat our cans and snack on our cat.
He's quick. I'll give him that.
Alf is fuzzy, short, he talks, and is generally resembling a Muppet.
Morning.
Frankly, I could use a little help.
I like the show, and you probably will too. It's on Monday nights on NBC. Don't miss it. This concludes my first segment with Cutaway, and hope you'll be looking for me on other shows. Thanks.
You're watching Cutaway, and I'm here with Christy DeZotti, our new contributor. And so, Christy, what are you going to have on later in the show?
Later in the show, I'm going to be taking a behind-the-scenes look at the making of the movie Ruthless People, so I hope everybody sticks around to watch.
You're watching Cutaway, and there's a windsurfer out there. And speaking about windsurfing, Cindy from Alameda High School is going to have a story about windsurfing on the bay.
Before you get into the sport of windsurfing, you should know what kind of equipment to use. We asked Bernard Wani of Willow Skate and Surf to show us the various kinds of equipment available for windsurfing.
For a woman who weighs maybe 115 pounds to 135 pounds, she doesn't need quite as big a board as this for beginning sailing and for light wind sailing, so she could get a board that is about 11 feet long, a board about this size.
For cold water and extra traction, Bernard suggests these 3mm booties, fingerless gloves for the summer, 5-finger gloves for winter use, and for extremely cold water, you can use a hood that covers you completely. Never done it before, but I'm certainly going to give it a try. If you are interested in windsurfing, there are several places to go. One is Willow Skate and Surf, or you could come down here to the beach. Talk with Philip Goodliff for California Sails. Both these are located in Alameda.
You're watching Cutaway, and we're still here at the San Leandro Marina Park, and I really don't see any dogs here yet, but Ashley Whippet is a frisbee-catching dog. This is a frisbee, in case you viewers out there don't know. He's a world-class frisbee-catching dog, and he's going to be next, so let's check him out.
Oh, you like that camera? Ashley, huh? Dynamite's the new star.
It's not too late.
Rip it good.
To rip it. Rip it good.
Look out. Hey, come on. Get out of my way.
Go for it, Ash.
I say rip it.
That's Ashley. Good one. Good one, Ashley.
Rip it good. I say rip it.
Coming up, don't change the channel, don't even get, sit down, right now. Now, be sure to watch, because here I come, at you, on cable TV, right after this.
Mama's looking strong, baby.
You're watching Cutaway, and I'm sitting here in San Leandro Park at the marina, and I'm just in a train that's not going anywhere. It kind of reminds me of Emmett, but in one of his first stories, he showed us his house in Oakland. So let's check it out.
I'd like to welcome you to my segment of Cutaway. For the next few weeks, I'll be doing different things for your enjoyment. Right now, I'm visiting the Worcester Art Gallery here in Oakland. Here at the Worcester Art Gallery, they have amazing things. They have the sculpture by Steve Dudley. It's made of twigs and wood, and it's all pieced together with little pegs. And it stands about eight feet tall, has horns on the top, a big mohawk, and a cowboy hat. We have a bird of paradise with a leprechaun. Homie the leprechaun and his buddies the stork and the flamingo. Our lady next door thought our yard was so cool, she gave it to us, and we painted him and helped him out and let him grow. He's quite a guy. He stands about 2 feet tall, and his name is Homie. And he has a friend, 7th Street Duck, and Elmo the squirrel. In the window, we have Owen's mannequin, and fashion designed by Emmett. And we have a juniper farther over with legs and boots coming out of it. It's quite neat. It's one of a kind in the neighborhood where this is located in Oakland. The legs out of the juniper are quite a spectacle to see. We have ex-Converse high tops I once wore. We have some drama props on there also. It's quite fabulous. I'd like to thank Owen Thomas for providing those here for the Cutaway Show. If you might think it's junk, but I really enjoy it. And I think our neighbors do also. And not only that, but it's been here about 8 months, and it never gets touched by any people. Just the little kids come by and play with it, but they always leave it alone. They never break it or touch it. And that's all the time we have for my segment here on Cutaway. Look for me in the future weeks, whereas we rap with other artists here in the local area, and we do some skate tips and other neat things. This is concludes my segment on Cutaway.
Watching Cutaway, and next we have Christy DeZotti. She's a senior at Arroyo High School and is one of our new contributors. Coming up next, she's going to be showing us her first story.
For my first feature, we're going to take a behind-the-scenes look at the making of the movie Ruthless People, starring Danny DeVito and Beth Midler.
She's out!
Help!
Get the chloroform!
Somebody! Please! Somebody help me!
Ruthless People features Bette Midler, who has made a recent comeback.
Do I understand this correctly? I'm being marked down? What is this, the bargain basement? I've been kidnapped by Kmart!
Her last hit was playing the role of a Beverly Hills housewife in Down and Out in Beverly Hills.
Or herpes! Oh my God!
This time, she's teamed up with Danny DeVito in Ruthless People. She plays a spoiled housewife who's kidnapped to her husband's delight.
Supply these things, and I will tell the jury you acted humanely. It might make the difference between life and the chair.
Barbara Stone is ghastly. She's, another Beverly Hills matron, but another breed. She's much coarser than the last Barbara that I played, but she's really very funny, very broad, opportunity for great slapstick, and I liked her a lot.
Bette is at her best doing comic roles.
I made up my mind just before I married my husband that I wanted to be a comic, that I was going to be funny in the pictures. I hadn't really been funny in pictures before. I think people love to laugh, and I think they're starved for it. And I think it's important that need be nourished.
Even though she is a popular box office draw, she doesn't expect to remain there long.
I don't expect to remain hot for any longer than 3 months at a time. Used to be able to sustain a career, but it's different now with all the media and all the exposure. It's very hard to remain original. I'm always surprised at any kind of success. I think that's part of my charm, that I don't expect, you know, I don't expect overwhelming success. I'm grateful for it. I'm happy for it.
The movie is produced by the same team that created Airplane, Jim Abrams, David Zucker, and Jerry Zucker.
People have often said that David was the brains behind the operation, but the truth of the matter is there are no brains behind the operation.
During the filming of Ruthless People, the Zazz team, as they are called, couldn't resist a few behind-the-scenes laughs.
Action.
Go jump, go, hop, go jump.
The next time, I want you to have more of a fierce expression on your face. Let me just demonstrate this.
Okay.
And watch this, Aldo. Okay.
The cast had to learn to work with not one, but three directors.
It wasn't like a surprise, but wait a minute, three? They didn't tell me that.
We sent Jerry to meet them first. And
they said, yeah, we don't tell people. Yeah,
If this next one is really good, I just want to show you that, you know, we're talking a 50. The next take
Let's
is good.
Try another one, okay?
If we don't print it, it's nothing.
Stop him!
Did you shoot at me?
No, you moron. There's police all over the place. Hundreds of them.
Do I look that stupid?
Yes, you do.
If you shot at me, where's your gun?
Well, you're too sharp for me. You got me figured out. I don't have one.
That is a brand new tire. Give me your keys.
I don't believe this.
Give the bag to Bozo, drop the gun, and put your hands in the air.
Who said that?
This could very well be the stupidest person on the face of the earth.
There were scenes that we thought, you know, and gags that we thought were really funny and didn't get much of a reaction. Fortunately, we were able to cut them. So, who cares, you know?
When our name gets above the title, when it says, you know, the Zuckers and Abrams present, you know, Ruthless People, then that'll be something.
I've seen the movie and I highly recommend it for rental. Bette Midler also is currently starring in another movie called Outrageous Fortune, which is supposed to be really good, but I haven't seen it yet. I'd like to thank you for watching me on my first feature story here on Cutaway, and I hope to see you on future shows. I'm Christy DeZotti, and now back to Mike and Brett.
Thanks, Christy.
Yeah, she did a really good job on that.
Yeah, I think she's a great addition to the show.
Cutaway, yeah, definitely. And to stay on that topic of movies, I think Jose is going to have a movie review for us.
Yeah, Jose is going to do a movie review on the Academy Award nominated film, Blue Velvet.
So let's check it out.
Blue Velvet is the new film by the uncompromising American director David Lynch. More famous for his early works, The Elephant Man, more recently Dune, and for his epic Eraserhead. In Blue Velvet, Lynch embraces us in a world that's so frightening but yet humorous.
I'm not crazy. I know the difference between right and wrong.
That's good.
Blue Velvet is a true masterpiece from a true American visionary and one of the best directors alive today. Blue Velvet opened in October to a series of mixed reviews. Whether the film is going to have commercial acceptance still remains to be seen. This is Jose Agustin Caballero for Cutaway.
You're watching Cutaway, and I'm just here with the tires, having fun. I think I'll just relax, playing it maybe, I don't know. I'm having so much fun here today. I don't know where Brett is. I kind of miss him. We'd have a lot of fun on here. I don't know. Well, for our next feature, we're going to be having John Burton from Alameda High. He produced a skateboard piece for us to the music by the Untouchables, Be Yourself. So let's check it out.
A friend of mine.
watching Cutaway. So, Mike, how do you think the show's going?
I think the show's going so well. I don't even know why we're doing this portion of the show, because it's, like, really boring.
Well, see, it's like a commercial. We don't have commercials on the show, so, like, so, now go get some chips, cookies.
Dips.
Whips. No, Mike.
Well,
milk.
Okay.
Get milk.
Milk and
Yellow
cookies.
American. And, well, I think the show's going pretty good.
Think so?
How'd you like my seal piece, Mike?
I liked it a lot. Like the fat seals, fat happy seals in the wharf.
Yeah.
It was special. Kind
of, yeah, it's very special.
Heartwarming.
Animal
touching.
Stories are always very special. They touch this little inner thing in us all, I think.
Think so?
Yes. And now here's Vince Flores.
Tell us more about
our next feature.
Next up here on Cutaway, we have time for a film clip, one from Bette Midler's new movie called Outrageous Fortune. And this clip features both Shelley Long and Bette Midler.
They don't give out passenger lists. You have to be police or FBI.
You are such a dip. This is all the FBI we need.
His luggage was totally over the weight limit. Can you imagine the gall trying to bribe an airline official?
Oh.
He offered me $100 to let it go through.
Oh, what a world, I'll tell you.
Excuse, please. I was hoping you would help me. How do I to say?
You say it quickly. I'm off in 3 minutes.
My father is coming here. No, I tell you from the beginning. My name is Anna. This is my sister, Elona. My half-sister, she does not speak English. My father, we have not seen him since we was babies in Prague. He sent us here in suitcase on train. We escape, you see?
No, I'm afraid I don't.
No, we get letter. He escaped. He is here. But we do not know where. We do not know which plane. Could be any plane, please. You tell us which plane. Please.
Absolutely not. I'm sorry.
Yes, on the English, on the heat. Not the other. No, 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 Papa. No, Papa.
Papa?
No, Papa.
That was the single biggest crock I've ever had the privilege to hear in my 19 years at this airline. I think that deserves something.
That was a clip from Outrageous Fortune, featuring Bette Midler and Shelley Long. And as of the spring of 87, it's running throughout the Bay Area. For our next feature here, we're going to preview a little bit of our next show. It's a feature about a falcon who was released back to the wildlife. Let's check it out.
Fortunately, we were able to release the bird in an area which is very remote. With the cooperation of landowners and people in the area who are aware that I have trained falcons for a number of years, the bird will be able to be watched by numerous different people. And fortunately, the ranch that the bird was released on, there's no gun hunting allowed, and the bird in its own right will have a very good chance of making it.
Close of Cutaway, Brett, and come on, Brett. I'm gonna be fooling around. This is some work. So what are you gonna have for the next show, Brett?
Oh, probably another animal piece.
Another animal piece?
I always have to have those special animal pieces.
So warm and sensitive. Yeah. I'm sure we have a lot of animal lovers out there watching Cutaway.
Yeah, what are you gonna have, Mike?
I don't know, Brett. I think I'm gonna have a skateboard piece, I don't know. That's like something we have here on Cutaway every week, so watch for that. And also, Brett, have fun, Brett. So I'm also gonna have a BMX bike story. A BMX bike story, Brett. What do you say to that?
That should be pretty interesting.
Interesting?
Yeah.
Well, I think this pretty much wraps up Cutaway. So
for Cutaway, I'm Brett Dixon.
And I'm Mike Williams, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
It's a wrap, dude.
Let's call it a wrap.
Let's call it a wrap. No, you should take that tie off. What are you trying to do?
I don't know. It just adds a little something to the show, you know?
Think so?
Yeah, just a little something.
I don't know. I think it's like you're just trying to pick up on the girls. I'm gonna put my jacket away. No, I don't think we're gonna do a song, but we're calling it a rap. Do you know what a rap really means?
What does a rap really mean, Lois?
I don't know. What do you feel about the show called Cutaway?
Cutaway, I never heard of it.